What is going on, IF Warriors? It's your boy Edward V, and today we're going to talk about how intermittent fasting actually burns fat faster based on the new studies that we have. Here's the cold hard truth, guys. If you want to lose weight, you have to reduce calories. But the unfortunate thing when you reduce calories is that your body will adapt to that reduction, making it harder for you to lose weight because then you have to continuously keep reducing your calories. Intermittent fasting may actually help you break out of that cycle. And I'm gonna go ahead and explain it and break it down in this video. Stay tuned. In my last video, I touched on the Japanese study from the Ikenawa Institute of Technology, in which they actually looked at the human blood to see metabolite compounds that showed increases in metabolism. Not the metabolism reducing or staying the same, but it being increased. And with that study being so powerful from all the different metabolites that were found, I needed to make a video that was heavily focused on that study. Now, before I jump into this new study that came out of Japan, I want to talk a little bit about something called metabolic adaptation. It is a thing that is very real. Study after study after study shows that the linear process of reducing calories does not work because the body becomes adapted to that caloric reduction and the rate of your metabolism reduces, thus the energy expenditure rate reduces. That is the reason why so many people try to offset this by trying to do things like diet breaks. A diet break is when you are at a caloric deficit and then instead of being at a caloric deficit, you go back to a caloric maintenance level for about a period of 2 weeks, something that was viewed in the Matador study that assisted them and helped them kind of upregulate the metabolism a little bit so that they can offset the metabolic adaptation that was happening from being in a caloric deficit. However, because you have to increase your calories to do this offsetting protocol to keep your metabolism from adapting, you're also not losing weight at that time. You're either staying the same or gaining some weight because you're at a caloric maintenance level. You then have to restart the process of being at a caloric deficit, and this process of going back and forth can take a long time for you to actually lose weight. And if you're just gung-ho and you want to not do the diet break and just be at a caloric deficit, you will probably fall victim to adaptive thermogenesis, which is metabolic adaptation, thus still making it harder for you to lose weight because your body is adjusting. That's the true starvation mode system. It's being at a low calorie diet for a long period of time in which your body adjusts its needs to the resources that it has. But study after study after study continues to show us interjecting a fasting protocol in and of itself can offset the metabolic adaptation phase and in many instances actually help you increase your metabolism. That's right, increase your metabolism. We've talked about the 16 clinical trials that show that muscle retention was greater in the intermittent fasting group that were doing 16-8 versus just the caloric restriction group. Now understand, both groups were at a caloric restriction, but the caloric restriction group were not doing any fasting protocol. The intermittent fasting group was doing the 16-8 fasting protocol. They retained more muscle. And we know, based on looking at your metabolism and fat-free mass, as well as lean tissue, that muscle is the primary driver for your metabolic rate because muscle burns calories at a high rate. So it increases your metabolism because energy expenditure is being utilized for your muscles to burn calories. Muscles burn a lot of calories. So the more muscle you have, the higher your metabolic rate would be. And because the 16-8 protected muscle versus just being at a caloric restriction, it was offsetting the metabolic adaptation that would happen by simply being at a caloric restriction. So I hope that this connected the dots for you so that you can understand why muscle in and of itself can increase or protect metabolic rate. Based on that small evidence, it shows that intermittent fasting has a potential benefit for protecting or increasing your metabolic rate. Now, there have been other studies looking at alternate day fasting, for example, with zero caloric intake that showed a 14% increase in resting energy expenditure, not a decrease, an increase in the groups that were doing the alternate day fasting. Also, there have been studies done back in the 90s run by Webner and McDonald in the British Journal of Nutrition that showed a 12, 36, and a 72-hour span, and resting metabolic rate was also increased in that group. And there's also another alternate day fasting study with zero caloric intake that showed a group of 8 men and a group of 8 women, after 21 days, there was no reduction in resting energy expenditure, further showing that there is somewhat of a connection with intermittent fasting and protection or increasing metabolic rate. Contrary to what people believe, people think that the starvation mode happens from not eating, but it's actually triggered from being in a very low calorie diet. Now, the reason that they thought that this was happening was just because of the muscle retention, and the hormone norepinephrine was going up, and that was protecting the muscle, thus also protecting metabolic rate. So those were the two things that they were creating the hypothesis for why this is seen in the fasting group, but it isn't seen in the non-fasting group. But the reason that the Japan study is incredibly important is that they did a non-targeted metabolemic analysis of the human blood. And previously, before this study, only 14 different metabolite compounds were even linked to fasting. But this study, from the sample group that they had, found 44 different metabolite compounds. And I'm going to touch on some of the very important compounds that were found that may actually be incredibly groundbreaking. Now, this Japan study was a 3-day fast, but it looked at the numbers at 10 hours, it looked at the numbers at 32 hours, at 58 hours. So they were looking at the numbers consistently, and the numbers were consistently going up throughout the days. And the metabolites were starting to be seen from 10 hours forward, peaking at the 58-hour mark. Now, three metabolites that diminish as we age is leucine, isoleucine, and ophthalmic acid. So when aging, those metabolites are reducing. This study showed that all three of those metabolites increase significantly in the human blood because of the fasting protocol. Now, we've seen studies, for example, in mice, that show that intermittent fasting improves lifespan. But this is directly looking at metabolites that are showing this process in action. It's huge that fasting can induce those three metabolite compounds. And anti-aging protocols also assist in muscle retention, which is why this lends to the retaining of muscle when intermittent fasting, thus increasing your metabolism, because muscle is the primary driver for your metabolic rate. But it takes it even further with more metabolites found in the blood. Two metabolites, purine and pyrimidine, were found in the blood as well. What did these two metabolites do? They increase protein synthesis. So the implications of these metabolite compounds that are being found is that intermittent fasting or fasting causes cells to change the type and quantity of the proteins that it needs to function. So it's an adaptation going in the opposite direction. Not an adaptation to calorie restriction, but an adaptation to fasting, which is then directly combating the adaptation that happens with calorie restriction, because those two metabolites, purine and pyrimidine, further induces protein synthesis. Protein synthesis is a process in which it uses amino acids as the building block to convert itself into muscle. So there is a clashing that ends up benefiting the end user. You, the person who is doing calorie restriction while utilizing an intermittent fasting protocol. The reason that this study is so powerful is that before this study, we only knew that muscle was being retained, but we didn't know exactly what the mechanisms were for the retention of the muscle. And there was only 14 different compounds ever found in the human body that related to fasting, 14 different metabolite compounds. But now there are 44 different metabolite compounds that were found, and further explain why intermittent fasting in and of itself, separate from caloric restriction, can provide long-term benefits to retaining the resting energy expenditure that you currently have, even though you're reducing calories. And a more powerful and possible further implication, which we don't know yet, we would have to do further studies, they would need to do bigger sample size, which is what these researchers are going to do in the future. They want to do bigger sample size, further study. They want to do all of those things to see how powerful this truly is. But these are metabolite compounds that they pulled directly from the human blood. The further implication can be that intermittent fasting may actually help you lose weight better than caloric restriction, not just fat loss, but just weight overall. Losing the weight faster than just caloric restriction, simply because it could improve or protect your resting metabolic rate. And that is fantastic news. I'm gonna link all the studies that I mentioned in this video below, and of course I'm linking the Japan study below as well, but I needed to make this video because this study is that important and I wanted to touch on some of those very important metabolites that were found in the human blood. And of course I want to thank my patrons for my Patreon, and I'm gonna go ahead and put their names